$1,000 to promote pizzas because she wanted to be known for her music rather than her pasta. She is Emmylou Harris, one of America's best-known country singers. Recently, she was in New Zealand for a special television appearance, and Philip Melchior caught up with her.
That's country has scored a coup. New Zealand's biggest international television money spinner screens across the United States, but until now, its stars have been short on glitter. Emmylou Harris and her larger-than-life road manager, Phil Kaufman, are here to change all that.
We've only eaten about 13 times.
I'm hungry.
Is there anywhere else you'd like to go while you...
Yeah, like to fly in like an airplane.
The angel from Alabama, the sweetheart of the rodeo. Emmylou Harris got on a plane in Nashville and got off in Christchurch. It's a long way for a big country star to come to do a one-off TV show. But country music has gone international. These days, it's as important to get to a shepherd in Southland as it is to reach that good old boy in Amarillo. After the breakup of her marriage, the award-winning country singer is on the road again, back in the public eye.
Graceful. She's graceful as possible. After 18 hours in the air. Ta-da!
That was it for the fanfare. All the star wanted to do was sleep. After a decade on the road, one hotel room is much the same as the next. Tucked away for 23 hours, in the morning, it was showtime.
Holy shit, there's a camera here!
At 36, Emmylou Harris is making changes. She's gone from high school cheerleader to every cowboy's fantasy, and she's still changing. Along the way, she's made country music classics, albums that turned to gold, songs that won a Grammy Award. But her career is turning. Her own songs gave her big hits in the 70s. Now she's writing again, and life is more relaxed.
Can we stop and have a beer before we get there?
That's right.
Once she didn't need TV shows. She could stick with what she loved, live concerts and her own band. Television rehearsals mightn't be her favorite game, but she's in town to perform.
Ladies and gentlemen, Emmylou Harris. Well, they'll all come see you when they'll ever hear you say it. Y'all come see us. Bye bye. Y'all come. Y'all come. Well, you all come see us when you can. Y'all come. Y'all come. Well, you all come see us now and then.
On a show like That's Country, Emmylou Harris really stands out. The show's producer believes that's exactly why she came.
America is a little bit like a sausage factory. They've got so many artists standing in queues waiting to appear that the rehearsal and actual recording sequence would probably take a matter of hours, as opposed to here we spend something like 3 days with each artist, and all the talent and energy of all the assorted skills like lighting and makeup and wardrobe, sound, are all focused on that one person and extracting from them and doing for them the best possible performance that we can.
And what's the end result of that process then?
Well, the end result is that the artists go back to America with probably the best performance I've ever achieved on television, because they've been able to spend a bit more time on it.
But television is unreal, artificial, not like a live concert. She finds it daunting that a television show can be played and replayed.
I don't like television in general, you know, and that's, I can make that blanket statement, because I don't feel like I'm really doing what I do on television. I feel out of context, I guess is the way to describe it. It's not this show or any other show, it's every show I've ever done. I always feel like, I want my band there, I want the live audience, I want it to go out and disappear.
If you don't like it, why do you do it?
It is a necessary thing in a way. It does reach people. And I got to a point a couple of years ago when I started feeling like I'd been a bit of a crybaby about it. You know, oh, the sound isn't right, or oh, I can't, you know, and I just, you know, other people do it, and I said, well, I've got to relax about it and just sort of be a professional.
That's Country screens across America on the Nashville cable network. Cynics might say that exposure is why she came. Manager Ed Tickner says that's not so. Were you conscious when you came here that it in fact did go on cable television, that it would be broadcast in the States in that way?
No.
You weren't, so that wasn't a factor?
No, it's not a factor. No. It's the time element is the factor. The fact that we had the available amount of time to come and mingle as a prelude to coming back. It's not a one-time thing. That's a game plan. I mean, we've done that over the years in new territories. We'll just go for a few days because there's a request by the press or a television show in Holland or Paris or wherever.
Christchurch 3ZB, proud to welcome the First Lady of Contemporary Country Music this morning, Emmylou Harris. Welcome to Christchurch and thank you for coming in. How long are you in Christchurch for?
For about 5 days.
Oh, to make That's Country.
Mm-hmm.
20 to 12, Christchurch 3ZB.
Oh, I won't have
it's all about promotion, raising the profile of the singer and her song.
By somebody else.
Cheers.
But if pet hometown projects get a plug, that's okay too.
You had to come to the Hall of Fame. Now I feel like I've done my duty as president of the Hall of Fame.
Yes, indeed. All of New Zealand.
All of New Zealand.
We'll do all the men's stores in Christchurch and see if we can get you something.
She came with the right songs, but not the right clothes. The night of the show, Emmylou needed something extra.
Tomorrow. But thank you anyway.
It's okay.
Finding it turned out to be harder than she expected.
More men's shops or something like that.
That is kind of awful. I mean, I'm worried about looking lumpy.
I think we could just tuck
New
it
Zealand,
in.
New Zealand lambskin?
It's just gorgeous. I hate it. No, I think it's right nice. It's you. You get a couple of tattoos, and you'll be all set, yeah.
Emmylou Harris is happy to tell jokes at her own expense. As a girl, her idols were television cowboys like Gene Autry and Roy Rogers. When she finally got to meet Gene Autry recently, he mistook her for another country star, Linda Ronstadt.
Because he turned around and he said, oh, pleased to meet you, Linda.
What did you say?
Well, I was told later that I should have said, pleased to meet you, Roy, but I'm not that fast on a comeback. Anyway, it was just one of those things.
You had to be there.
Yeah, you had to have been there.
Fine, thank you very much.
If she was putting herself down, she didn't need anyone to build her up. It was her star quality that made her a catch for That's Country, and the homegrown stars were happy just to be on the same stage.
I think she's just superb. She's from another planet, I think, sometimes. She just sings unlike anybody else in the world.
I've had a 69 Chevy with a 396 in the head and a burst on the floor. She's waiting tonight down in the parking lot outside the 7-Eleven store. Me and my father, son, he built her spread out, scratching, he rides with me. We only run for the money, got no strings attached. We shut 'em up and then we shut 'em down. Tonight, the streets just...
I think it comes right at the tempo there, doesn't it?
Flying round the world to sing with a band you've never even heard before isn't easy. The singer and the band need time to get acquainted. It's a sign of the changing times that after years together, her famous hot band is gone.
I had to let my band go, her people who were loyal to me and who looked to me for their livelihood and who never let me down on a single show, played great, and who depended on me, and I had to say, look, I just can't keep you on retainer. I've got to take some time off.
This is what management does to keep keep stars from doing and this is Emmy's favorite tape, and we get paid exorbitant amounts of money to have this technical ability here.
On a trip like this, the support act is down to two. Phil Kaufman to handle the humor, Ed Tickner to make sure the promotion gets results.
What do you think, Ed?
I think you got a lot of trouble.
I think we got a lot of trouble.
After I won a couple of awards, my prize went up, and I was actually able to tour and make money. But it's funny how when something like that happens, your expenses somehow inflate with you. And the last tour I did, I grossed $1 million, didn't make a cent, because there was it got out of hand. So then I got back to a more grassroots level, which I'm more comfortable with anyway. Thank you very much. I just couldn't resist you people. I've been sitting out there enjoying the music. I've never done this without a band, but we're trying. Making believe that you still love me.
In her weekend in New Zealand, the real grassroots gave her the best time. A borrowed guitar at a tiny country music festival on a farm way out of town.
Still I'll always grieve.
Came to listen and never meant to sing, but this was the real world. An audience so close, you could see the whites of their eyes.
Hold you close when you're not with me. You're somebody's love. You'll never be mine. Making believe.
The applause isn't always matched by record sales, but philosophical singer isn't rushing to change his style.
I'm fortunate that what I did at one point sold, and if it's going to drop off for whatever reasons, then that's just the way it's going to be.
You've had 9 years now, really, as a star.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, I guess.
Do you look into the future with any sort of panic or anything like that?
No, I don't. Maybe I should, but I don't really, because I've got a contract with Warner Brothers. They still got to pay me when I deliver these records. And I still got ideas. I'm still excited about my music. And I just got to assume that excitement is going to be generated to, you know, enough people to keep me, you know, with a label. And that's the most important thing, you know, is to have your excitement.
After 3 days rehearsal, it was time for lights, camera, and action. Backstage, the star was getting her final gloss.
They're always moving for the lips. Always. It's because I have no lips. They have to draw them in. I admit to it. I remember a record review in which the girl described my music as thin-lipped. I mean, she was viciously putting the album down, and she couldn't think of anything else bad to say, so she started knocking my lips. Thin-lipped music.
Out front, the theater is filling up with the audience that gives the tape show a live feel. Good old boys from Sydenham and Kashmir take their seats. In her dressing room, Emmylou House is the star, waiting for the call.
Emmy! Sorry, no strumming. I have to take this. We gotta go to work. Gotta go to work. Thank you.
I don't like to work.
Oh, work.
Live from the Christchurch Town Hall, Television New Zealand presents That's Country with...